Here is the best virtual DJ mapping that you need, and you'll be learning a step-by-step guide on how to put it into very good use, irrespective of whether you are a beginner DJ, an intending DJ, or a pro DJ. By the end of this video, you would have learned all the basic things that you need to know about virtual DJ mapping, as well as how it connects with your controller. For those who are beginner DJs, you get to appreciate the entire process of DJing with this mapping. Gives you the opportunity to practice and get to see how these things work, so that by the time you start going into using the controller, you would have learned so much that on a very good day you wouldn't have learned if you are waiting for the opportunity to have access to a controller first. However, for those who are already existing DJ or pro DJ, you also learn how you can have a full feel of the controller at the same time here on the keyboard by just having some few setup done, and then how you'll be able to maximize your time. Remember, you are into business and you need to maximize your time at every given opportunity that you have, because it's not every time that you are going to be moving with all those heavy gadgets at every given time. So this is what you need to understand. Like what we have here now, we are going to be looking at like what the requests I have here, the essential keys for smooth transitioning, scratches, loops and cues. These things are very, very important, especially if you don't have the proper setup done. That is why I have this full guide for you. We are having our setup here that will do help us perfect these things very well, just like this very one. For those who have access to it, you know what I'm talking about. You get to appreciate how it works at this level. This one we are going to be working at, they all operate at the same level, but there are different changes. This one will work for us for this very one, and then this other one too will work for those who are using the number keys for their drum. So this is the one we'll be working with. You set it safe. So the first thing you need to be aware of is you must be able to load your track within the shortest possible time. Look at my screen here. There is no track on the deck after loading your virtual DJ. Instead of constantly rolling your hand here, all you have to do is you go with control arrow key up. Look at it, the arrow key up. Just take note here. You see, let me take it here. You see, our cursor is not here, but the moment I go with control up, you see it's selected. So you can type in the track based on the folder you have. You have your folders here for your track list. So this will ensure that you build your playlist by this right hand side. You drag them to this very side. Then in the event you have the track that you selected, let's say for example, let me pick any sound. I saw a particular sound, like this particular sound. Let's have, this is the sound we want to load into our deck. We have two deck here, we want to load the track. All you have to do is by the time you do that, you tap on this down arrow key. You see it's already on it. Then you go with this open bracket. Look at it, you can see it's already loaded. So to start it, you can see you have your letter C, then you have your J, then you have your H. So they have different variant of starting the sound, but let me break it down step by step from the top of the keys arrangement so that you get to appreciate what we have here. We have the first set here, which is for this finger drumming. It also makes it possible for you to load your sound effect just the way you see it here. So you can load any sound effect of your choice on this first set. For those who are using DAW arrangement, it's still okay. Then you have your next set. This is for your hot cues as well as your loops. So for the hot cues, you go with control one, control this, then alternate this to move in between hot cues. To set is control, and then to move is alternate, depending on the number of cue points you set while the track is playing or even when the track is not playing. Then the next thing that follows is you have your shift alternate to delete each of the cue point that has been set. Then for the loops, which are these things here you are seeing here, you see loop here, when you tap on one, let's go with this one that is selected. You have this your tap key that takes care of switching between deck. You can actually see if I tap on it, it goes to this deck. If I tap on this again, it comes back. So what you do is the deck that is selected, most of the anchors in between here work with the deck that is selected. Don't worry, I'm breaking it down step by step. So for you to set a particular cue loop, once you tap on letter 4, you see the loop is active irrespective of the deck that is selected. It will be setting it. So to increase the loop, you go with 9. You see it's doubling the loop. To double it down into half, the 8 will do it. Then this one takes care of moving you to a particular hot cue point, the number 8. Then we have our this minus. This will take care of starting up your record in the event you want to record your DJ mix. But before you do that, you need to set the file to the particular format that you want, whether MP3 or anyone. The next thing that will follow is, now we are coming down to this big arrangement here. So after getting your track loaded, the next thing we have here is this letter Q and letter W. This is to ensure that you have a very good way to start the song. Let me remove this here. I'm going to load another sound on a particular sound on this. So this track is here now. So you now have this. This will ensure that you start the deck one without having any challenge. In the event you are scratching and you just want to drop, look at it. So this is it for the first deck, that is deck one. Then for the deck two, in the event you don't want to be stressing yourself looking for the default deck, with this you easily start the second deck, which is this one. Look at it. So even without making it a default deck, because these are fixed for deck one and deck two, then the overall settings here work with the default deck. What do you mean by the default deck? The deck that you selected. So this means, as we are here now, this one is already our default deck, which is this. Then every action we'll be executing here will be on this particular deck, just like what you have here to start. You start this way, or you go, which is the same thing, but they have different variant. And to create with pitch, you go this way. So that is it. Then to start on a normal, then to constantly adjust your track for smooth beat matching. In the event they are not perfectly beat matching, you use this left arrow key and right arrow key. Just look at the movement of the wave as I'm tapping on it. This will ensure that you fuse in. Then to synchronize, you go with shift this. You can see the two tracks are perfectly synchronized. Then to adjust your BPM upward, you go with this. You can see how the BPM are changing, or you go with this, control this. You can see how the BPM is coming down too. So this is the basics. Then you now have other stuff just like this. Let's take for example, we are starting it like this. This one will take care of breaking. You start, so you can see the pitch is very high. Then you now reset, go back to your normal stuff. So this will ensure that everything works perfectly as you are just starting to use the mapping. Then there are situations where you want to scratch. Very nice scratches. Look at it. The letter L is okay, but we have another variant which is with the letter A. So in the event you want to scratch and drop, that is it. Then in the event you want to play some kind of scribbling on the deck, that means one deck must be playing while you play the scribbling on another deck. Take for example this one that will be starting here. So now that we are here, it means our default deck will have to be here. So yes, okay, don't finish. Okay, make I just round up something.
So you never come down?
Eh?
They don't come down.
I don't think they never come down. More words, more. Make I round up this in sharp. So while this is here, our deck that we'll be scribbling with will be on this side. So this column key will take care of playing around with our crossfader. Look at it. So that is chopping off this other deck. Then if you decide to go with this one, it's going to be chopping off this other deck. Look at it. So, and it has a way it plays around to ensure that just the way your deck behave, that is the same way this particular key is behave. So to perfectly get this done properly, let's say for example we are starting. Then we are going to switch to this other deck. Now that we are switched to it, you can see. So now you have seen how the whole process works. We have the letter S that takes care of stopping any of the deck. Then remember these number keys are used to set cue points. So to set loops on a normal day, but control with it will set cue or cue point. Then the next important thing that you also look at is, there are situations where you want to scratch and drop. How do you do that? You have your letter N and your B, this your B will automatically switch, or G will automatically switch to the next deck. Then you have your letter Z that takes care of cloning your deck. You can give these things a try to get to see how they work. Then you have your page up, page down that will take care of move your crossfader just the way you do on your normal deck. Then you have your open bracket, your backward slash, the control of it will constantly switch the frequency. Then and a host of other this, and I'll be putting more guide as time goes on. Thanks once again. For those who don't have access to DVR mapping, I will leave the link in the description box where you have access to it, so that you get to practicalize and then you get to see how. Do well to check the channel. There are more videos coming. So see you guys once again in the next video.